Speaking of hard R's, man. Speaking of hard R's, y'all remember the skit channel? The cringy skit channel that we watched? They got some new bangers, bro. They got some new bangers that they dropped. And this one is Evil Sun Demands. Get this. This is why I bring up the hard R. This is why I bring up the hard R. Look at what they're playing. Look at what they're playing, bro. Evil Sun Demands a PlayStation 5 from Broke Mom. What happens next is shocking. Yo, chat. All I'm going to say is, yo, if you are easily disturbed or triggered by some shit, you are not going to want to watch this. Somebody said Killer Roy. I'm so ready to watch this, bro. Holy shit. Now, Twitch, I don't know where this shit is about to go and how crazy it's about to get, but just remember, all of this is really for educational purposes. Trying to show y'all to stop treating y'all mom the wrong way. Xbox players, I get it. You hate the system that you have. But treating your mom like this so that you can get the superior system, the superior console, this is not the way, okay? Do better.
Feel like Pharrell in 07 on my shoes, ice cream. Make stars, stop them out, it's a man down. Baby Milo custom PC getting fanned out. Not from the block, I'm from the H and we don't play around. Catch him at a red light with a nerf gun, we gon' spray him down.
Boys, do you mind keeping it down? I just got back from work and I just need a little nap before I head out for my second shift at the restaurant.
Shh, Mom, you're ruining the game.
Lucas, please just quiet down.
Mom, shut up. You're ruining it. Mom. Mom. Mom.
At least he got some
Mom,
feelings.
Please.
Damn.
Get up. Mom, are you okay?
Oh, this must be at the end, bruh. Look at that. Look at that. She got $439. That's either the bills or how much she got left. It can't be how much she got left in her account at all. Can't be, bro. Look at this shit. Yo, hold on. Let me talk about something real quick. I know a lot of y'all are young, so y'all not going to know about this. But they do not put past due on your fucking mail. They're not allowed to just write past due on your mail like that. Like they cannot do that. Like just imagine, bro. Like that's so fucked up.
Mom.
Yeah, baby.
I need to get a new PS5. This old Xbox keeps crashing my games.
And this fucking black streamer just keeps talking about how it's superior and it's kind of pissing me off.
You said you'd get me one a month ago.
I'm trying.
Aw.
Just a lot of things I have to take care of before I can do that. I'll get you one soon, okay?
That's what you always say. But I think you're just being lazy. Hurry up and give me my PS5.
Hey, yo! What? I ain't gonna lie, sis. You too lenient. You too lenient. She thinking about murdering him.
Ma, bring me a Pop-Tart.
One second, honey.
Yo, is this your child or your abusive boyfriend? Do something!
Come on, hurry up. You're so slow.
As fast as I can.
Yo, what game is he playing where you have to use the controls like this? Like, what the fuck is this?
Slow.
Oh, wait, hold on. It's Xbox. It's literally only, like, it's either... It's either fucking Halo or some sports game.
As fast as I can.
Strawberry Pop-Tart? Okay, hold on. She got style. Who the fuck puts Pop-Tarts on a plate, bruh? You don't give me a napkin?
All right. Here you go, honey.
Finally. Oh, strawberry flavored? I wanted blueberry.
Sorry, honey. You said they were your favorite last week.
If you actually cared about me, you know that I changed my mind yesterday.
Are you disgusting. Serious?
I want blueberry ones. Do you think you could handle that?
Who would ever accept this shit?
Mom gotta tell this broke boy get a job.
Sure, honey. I'll get some after work today.
Ugh. My game crashed again.
You got an Xbox, dude.
Mom, hurry up and get me that new PS5.
Yo, I promise you, like, I don't just be searching up, like, Xbox, PlayStation 5 related shit. It just pops up for me, and I'd be like, it's like things around me is hearing what I'm saying. It's like, this nigga keep talking about Xbox and PlayStation a lot. Throw this skit right there. Throw this skit on this recommended, bro. I'm sorry, bro. They're just giving me ammo, man.
Hey, are you coming in?
But now I understand it. It's like, you really got to think about it. You can't blame the kid when it's like trauma of only having an Xbox. Like, it's going to make you react like that. Seeing other people around you experience such joy and such like games that are like really, really good, and you're stuck on a shit system, it can make you release inner demons. And you know, it's trauma behind that, bro. It's really trauma behind that.
To work today?
Yes, I'm coming to work today.
So I think that's what this is actually trying to explain, bro. I think And like, probably the moral is like, if you have a kid or if you're planning on getting a kid, stay away from the Xbox console, or this is what's gonna happen. And I'm not even, I wish I was joking. I wish I was.
My shift starts in about an hour. Oh, I was gonna ask you if there was a chance I could pick up some extra shifts at work. I wanna make some extra money so I can get my boy
Daisy with the
nice
wins donated $5.
Yeah, I could
when
actually
you gone, listen to
work
eat.
The graveyard shift.
Great. Thanks, I'll work a double shift tonight then.
Great, I'll see you then.
Thanks, Mr. Wilson.
It's crazy how eager and how jobs really quickly accept when you ask to take on more time. But the second you need to reduce some time, like, I don't know. It's like a big hassle. But the moment she was like, yeah, I was trying to see if I could pick up some. Of course, yes, of course, yes. Like, yo, fuck these jobs. Like, dude, that's so fucked up, bro. Do better for yourself, man. Do better for yourself, all right? Know your fucking worth, y'all. Know your worth, bro.
Mrs. Taylor began picking up extra shifts at her job to help pay the overdue bills. She even started cleaning people's houses for money so she could afford a PS5 for her son.
W mom for like how much she cares and, you know, is trying to support her household and things like that. But L mom for how she's letting the son walk all over her, bro.
Working began to take a toll on her health, but she kept pushing through it with a single goal in mind: to keep her son from knowing how much they were actually struggling for money.
That's dope. That's dope, and that's deep, and that's real. So shout out to her for that. But like, bro, you letting your son walk all over you? That's just the L. That's just never acceptable at all. And this shit got past due written all over the damn. He walking past that and don't see it. Xbox. He can't really like read like that.
Oh, come on.
Dude, I've got this. You can't stop it.
Call of Duty, Skyrim, sports, and I don't know what the other game is, man. Of course, dude. A fucking course, man.
Oh,
what the hell? Oh. Dude's like playing like this and like flipping the like what the hell is he doing? What game is this, bruh?
Oh, dude, I'm beating you badly. You can't even touch
sink any day.
Miss Taylor can clean my sink. Yo, you know what? I talked about pet peeves before. One of my biggest pet peeves in movies is when like somebody's dancing and there's choreography, and then they point at somebody to do it, and then they look at two moves and then immediately know the whole dance for the whole fucking session of the dance routine. It just, that bothers me so much. And another thing is when people are playing games in movies like this, and then you look at their screen and it's like Grand Theft Auto, where you never have to play games. You are never playing Grand Theft Auto like this. Like, at least make it a fighting game, bro. There was one movie I'm watching, it was like from the 90s, and they were playing like this, bro. And it was Super Mario, bro. It was Super Mario. And the character wasn't even moving. I don't know why they cut to the screen. The character was not moving. He was just sitting on his Yoshi. Like, that shit's so annoying.
Come on, man.
Bro, they'd be like this. I'd be like, ugh! It just takes me out, man.
You're cheating or something.
Cheating.
Yo, Leroy, make a song and help your mom out. Damn!
Hey, boys.
I ain't reacting to this music no more, bro. This shit's disgusting and disturbing. I did not know this was his past.
Do you mind keeping it down? I just got back from work.
Tell me why! Tell me why!
And I just need a little nap before I head out for my second shift at the restaurant.
Shh, mom. You're ruining the game.
You're ruining it. You're ruining
please,
it.
Please, just quiet down.
You're ruining it.
Mom, shut up. You're ruining it.
I wish
I'm having fun. Just try not to scream so much.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh, dude. Just got you bad, man.
As much as you stay on this game, you look like you literally don't leave this spot and you getting your ass whooped.
On.
This nigga's like pressing the start button and shit, bruh.
I don't know, man. She's just like that.
She's so annoying.
I know.
My mom doesn't do that.
Wait a minute.
I know.
My mom doesn't do that.
Is that a Switch controller? Wait, you can use the Switch controller on the Xbox? Wait. wait. Wait, you mean it? Did they just say fuck it? They're like, fuck it, we need another controller. Just get the Switch controller.
Game crash.
Yo, I'm fucking dead.
You know what? I'm out of here. I hate coming to your house.
Wait. Let me restart it. It'll work. Please don't leave.
Dude, you have an Xbox. I can't take this, man.
Man, I don't even know why I'm friends with you.
Tell him.
You never have snacks. Your AC always turns off and your Xbox keeps crashing.
It's an Xbox, bro. You're broke.
You know what? Don't ask me to hang out again. Everything about your life sucks.
Damn! This is crazy, but it's the harsh reality. And I feel like this is gonna shock and hurt some people, but like, I feel like a lot of Xbox console only people need to watch this just to open their eyes. Like, this doesn't have to be you. This doesn't have to be the life that you live. It's fucked up, man. This shit's sad. This is really eye-opening. Like, I'm gonna take it easier on Xbox players now. Because this made me realize, you know, just how bad things are, man. Like, I already knew things were bad just because, like, that's the console you had. But it's like, damn, like, shit is really, really fucking bad. So, I'm actually slow down and chill out. It's not funny, bro. It's not, you know, it's not funny to make fun of, you know, people like this. So, damn. Just keep your head up and, you know.
That's probably why your dad left you and your boat, Mom.
God damn! Oh my, yeah. Yo, the mom ain't even do nothing mean to him. All she been trying to do is like, really all she said was to clean your room or some shit. I don't even think she been nagging this dude to get a job. All he has to do is clean his room, bro. And she ain't even say nothing to you. Like, what are you talking about? She's annoying. Ah, shit.
Hey, baby. Why'd your friend leave? He just got here like 20 minutes ago.
It's because of you. You don't care enough about me to give me the one thing I asked for.
Oh my God, bro.
I wish Dad was here. At least he know how to take care of a family better.
I'm pretty sure the dad took the PlayStation. He probably had a PlayStation. He probably took that shit too. Yo, if you don't beat his ass, take his system away. It hardly works anyway. Bruh, if she just... It looked like the rest of her bills was like $400-something. If she just took the Xbox and sell it, then she'll only have like $380 left to pay, like, bills to pay, bro. Like, that thing's gotta be at least $20, bro. Gotta be.
Come here, sit down.
What is it, Mom?
No way she got the system.
I wanna go to my room already.
Oh, hush. Sit down and close your eyes.
No way she got the fucking system.
Go on. Open it.
No way she got the system. Oh my. Hold on.
Oh my God.
Hold on.
You got it.
Wait, Mama. This box look kind of small.
Xbox, PlayStation, and Switch. I can confidently say only time I use my F-tier Xbox is to watch Netflix, lol.
Finally. Took you long enough.
Am I tripping?
Yeah, I had to work a little extra just to get it for you.
I can't believe it. I can play so many games on this.
That is the truth, ain't it? That is the truth.
I'm glad you like it, honey.
He doesn't deserve it at all, but like... She really did that shit. Like, what? Fake as hell.
I also got you Pop-Tarts. This time, blueberry.
See? That's what I'm talking about.
Bro, he's got too good of a mom to, like... Man, he did not deserve her. He does not deserve her, bro.
Mom.
He does not deserve
mom,
her, man.
Please, get up.
She done passed out.
Mom, are you okay?
It's okay, honey. I'm fine.
No. You're not fine. You just passed out on the floor.
And I've only got the console. I have no games with it. Get up. Come on. We gotta go to the store.
I've just been working a lot. I guess I was just tired.
Mom. Why have you been working so much?
Have you been... What?
The truth is, honey, we were behind on bills. Our rent was due and you wanted the PS5, so I thought I could... do a few more shifts and take on a part-time job as a maid cleaning people's houses to make sure we had enough money.
This is pissing me off.
But Mom.
He does not deserve her.
Your health.
He does not deserve her.
You really need a rest for a few days.
Oh, honey, I can't. Our rent is due in 2 days. It's okay. If I work 4 double shifts and clean one house, I'll make the $1,000 we need to make rent.
I didn't know we were struggling for money.
You didn't ask, bitch.
If I had known, I wouldn't have pushed you so hard to give me that PS5.
Shut up, dude.
Mom, I care more about you.
You don't act like it.
I'm so sorry for acting like a spoiled brat. James.
He only acting like this because he got the PS5.
Dante, love your streams. They make my day. Hope everything is going good for you. Much love.
Yo, much love to you too, bro. Six. If he really cared about her, flip it. Flip that PS5. I don't know how the fuck she got that shit. I don't know where she found that shit. I'm assuming she did it through hard work and she ain't sucked no dick for it, all right? I ain't gonna do that to her. She been through a lot already. But flip it, bro. Sell that shit. You could at least get like $800, $900 for that shit, bro.
I should have been grateful that you were
Or, bro. If he really was bad at it as much as he be on the game, this nigga needs to enter a tournament and win. But that's just like some Disney movie. This nigga is an asshole. He's terrible at the game. He's losing to his friend that plays it part-time. Fucking clown.
Working for both of us.
It's okay, honey. I can handle it.
Mom, you need to get some rest. Let's get you to bed. I'll bring you some medicine and water.
Thank you.
I guess he's trying. Yeah, or start streaming, dude. Like, contribute.
I'm tired.
Like, it's different if you're trying to... attempt to chase something, but you're just playing the game for free, like doing nothing, bro.
There you go.
Thank you.
At least he's trying now, bro. Sucks that she had to pass the hell out. He's still an L son. What the fuck?
I hope this helps.
It does, honey. Thank you.
Wow, is that did you unlock the carry motion?
I'm just gonna rest for a little while, okay?
Okay. Sound like something was knocking at the door, bro. He's gonna get right back on the game.
As his mom was getting some rest, he went online and posted his brand new PS5 for sale. After many hours of waiting, he finally finds someone who wants to buy it from him for $1,000.
Okay!
This would help him and his mom pay rent.
I want y'all to take another lesson learned from this, bro. Another lesson learned. Notice how he went back and flipped the PS5. He didn't even try to sell the Xbox. Cause you ain't gonna get shit for that. Good shit, Leroy. That's how he felt when he was selling the PlayStation. Tell me why. Damn. I got a little bit more respect for him now that he sold the PlayStation though.
Mom, how are you feeling?
Fine, yeah, I donated $20.
You remember that one Darman episode when the racist woman was whipping that cripple that was weird ASL?
Yeah, they took the video down, bro. They took the video down.
Mom, it's fine. Come here for a second.
I really need to.
Mama, listen!
Look.
Oh, shit! Still an L? He is. I need to see more. Like, this ain't enough. This shit is cool, though.
Where did you get $1,000, Lucas?
I sold the PS5.
Baby, why?
Because I wanted you to take the next few days off. I knew we needed that money by tomorrow.
Yeah.
But you've been waiting for the PS5 for so long.
We all have.
I did, but when I saw what it did to you, I couldn't keep it. Mom, you mean the world to me. Seeing how much you sacrifice every day just so I can have the best life I can made me realize I was taking all of that for granted.
Yo, if you got your mom and you have a PlayStation system, go hug your mom, all right? You don't know what she went through to make sure you had that damn system, okay? You don't know what the fuck she went through to have that damn system. If you got a mom and you got the PS4, you don't know what she did, what she went through to have that damn system.
Why are you talking about Xbox?
If you have the Xbox console and you got your mom with you, she may not fuck with you like that, but maybe she trying in the background, bro. Maybe she trying in the background. Go give her a hug, bro. Go give her a hug and tell her to keep it up, man. Keep it up. And shit like that, because you don't know what she's trying to... She probably trying, man. She really trying, all right?
I don't care about the PS5, Mom. Cap. I care about you. So, take these next few days off to rest and get better. That's the best gift you can give me.
Aww.
Oh, honey. I love you so much. You're such a wonderful young man. I'm proud of you.
Well, now he is. Like, he was a dick before, bro. I ain't gonna lie, this one thing ain't gonna change.
I have the next few days off. Do you wanna go to the park and spend some time together?
Of course, Mom. I'd love that.
Okay.
Sometimes we don't see how much our parents sacrifice for
us. You really don't.
But it's important to take a moment to be grateful for all they do. Yeah. It might not seem like much, but every sacrifice they make is always to give you the best life they can.
Mm-hmm.
We hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to share it with your friends and family. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this.
I'm not gonna lie. I like that one. That was really good, bro. That was really good. And I feel like there was like actually like a lot to take away from that. Like, bro, appreciate your moms, bro. You literally don't know what your mom isn't telling you. Like, if there's probably some shit that's tough for her to pay for. Like, you probably just got a new car. She probably just got you a new system. She probably got you a new PC setup. A lot of people are wanting to stream. She probably got you a whole bunch of streaming stuff. Like, bro, just appreciate them. Your mom, your dad, whoever the fuck you live with, you feel me? rated Artie, thank you for the five. The Univ, thank you for the five, bro. Okay. There's another video. There's another video here that I wanted to check out too. And these ones are always funnier, bro. These ones are always like OD, bro. Whenever it deals with racism and shit, bro. This one is racist cops arrest black family. What happens next is shocking. every time it has to do with racism, they go beyond like some shit, bro.
Y'all are both under arrest for stealing those hot dogs.
What?
Who the fuck is just stealing hot dogs? That's what I want to know.
I tell my mom I love her every day because one day I know she's not gonna be here and I gotta cherish her.
Facts.
Also, shout out to moms everywhere.
Appreciate your mama. I mean, appreciate everybody, whoever you fuck with while they're here, like, you know?
Fred donated.
If you're friends with them, if they're your parents,
Fox fanboys,
relatives, all that shit.
Company as an excuse, all that money to have the most mid console in existence.
Bro, money don't mean nothing when you don't got nothing to spend it on. That's all I'm saying.
We didn't steal anything.
Don't lie to me. I know you're kind, and you people are always stealing things.
Yo, you see what I'm talking about? Like, damn. Like, if you want real racism, like, niggas do that shit behind your back. Ain't no, like, racist people ain't brave enough to say that shit in front of people. Unless they, like, already in a heated argument or, like, not even in a heated argument, they don't be saying shit like that. They be too scared, bro. This shit is crazy.
We didn't steal anything, okay? We have these fair and square. You can ask the man over there.
I've heard enough. Officer Cletus, arrest that kid. I'll handle this woman.
What?
You are under arrest!
That's what you get for stealing, little monkey boy.
Yo, what the f- Yo, ain't no way, bro. Ain't no way they doing this shit. Not during Black History Month, bro. Not during Black History Month, they not doing this shit, bro.
You are under arrest! If you don't stop, I will use lethal force. Down.
Oh my god.
Hello guys, today's video is sponsored by War Farm Adventure, but more of them later.
Yo, they agreed to put an ad on it, like, Word Farm Adventure? I can't fuck with you. It's kind of weird that you, because when you do a sponsor, the sponsors have to see the video that it's on, like, and what the video's in, which means they watched that first part and were like, yo, fuck it. Yeah, just do it, bro. Fuck it, just put it in there, man. We don't even need to see what he said. Just put it in there.
How you feeling, baby? You excited?
Of course, Mom. I can't believe you can win $1 million just by playing Word Farm Adventure.
I know, honey, that's amazing. Plus, you'll be learning a lot of new words and how to spell them, which is something that you need because you'll be going to college.
Ain't no way they just did that shit. Ain't no way they just did that shit.
You'll be the...
Okay, at least it's them doing it. Like, imagine the cops are, like, beating the mom in the sun. And they're talking about the fucking... Yo, man, oh my gosh. I've learned a lot of these words and vocabulary that I'm using them playing Word Farm.
By playing Word Farm Adventure.
I know, honey, that's amazing. Plus, you'll be learning.
Did you hear how I call them monkey boy?
Them,
Word Farm.
Which is something that you need.
They don't have monkeys on the farm, but hey, there's one right here.
First one in our family.
Stop moving.
College. Grandma would be so proud.
This shit is crazy, bro.
What's wrong, Mom?
It's just that ever since Grandma got cancer, we have some very expensive medical bills, and I don't know how much longer I can keep taking loans out to pay for it.
Captain, look at this.
What is it, Cletus?
Look.
What are these thugs doing at our event?
Oh my god, get the fuck out of here, bro.
I bet they're planning on stealing the money or shooting up the place.
Jesus!
People look like them. Like my pop always tells me, if it's black, it's selling crap.
Mom.
I've never heard, if it's black, it's selling crack? Bro, I've heard of black don't crack, but if it's black, it's selling crack? What a flip. What a flip. What the hell? What am I watching?
Mama used to tell me, if it's black, you better watch your back.
Don't worry, Mom. I've been practicing Word Farm Adventure every single day. We'll for sure win this.
You're such a smart, special boy, Jeremiah. And you know what? You're right. We've been practicing every day. There's no way we won't win this.
That's the spirit, Mom. Come on, we're gonna be late.
Come on, Cletus. Let's go arrest them before they cause any trouble.
Yes, Captain.
Oh my god, this is
crazy.
Wow,
this is amazing.
What the fuck? You can tell the people who made this, like, have never experienced any type of racism at all, bro. Like, what the fuck is this writing?
Can we go get a hot dog?
Of course, baby.
Hey, look over there.
Excuse me, sir.
Bunch of fucking thugs. It's a mom and her son.
How much is it?
It's $3 for one hot dog, $5 for two.
Wow, what a great deal. Let me get two.
One more thing. Because this is an annual War Farm Adventure contest, if you're able to solve this cross war puzzle, you can get in for free.
Now that sounds like a deal. Come on, Jeremiah, let's get us some free hot dogs.
We got this.
Here you go.
I am asleep.
After completing the puzzle, I'll give you more facts about War Farm Adventure. You see, guys, War Farm Adventure is the perfect combination of
things. Okay, at least the ad kind of cool. Hold on.
War Farm Adventure allows you to solve cross war puzzles and complete War Scrabble missions. There's so many levels to choose from.
It's promo. Yes, it's promo. A fucking ad.
Ayo, can you imagine the scriptwriter sitting at his desk like, oh yay, this shit finna hit. I can't believe.
Fred, oh yeah, this shit finna hit. This the one.
Homeboy should have used all that word farm to pay for his granny's medical bill.
Bill? Such as the farm.
Oh yeah, they're gonna fuck with this.
And many more coming very soon.
Oh my god.
The more you win, the more tasks you get to complete. And the quicker you get to
this is so crazy, bro. They really like
the War Farm Adventure app is available.
I guess you know you gotta get your bag, man.
You can download it for free on the link on the description in this video. And if you click on the link on the description,
yeah, there's yeah, you gotta give out positive messages, but at the same time, you know, you gotta get a bag behind the messages, you feel me?
In order to work.
We did it.
High five, baby. Here you go, sir. All done.
Congratulations, guys. You guys did it perfectly. Here you go. Two free hot dogs courtesy of War Farm Adventure.
Thank you, sir. Here you go, baby.
Yo, them hot dogs look good. I want some hot dogs, man.
Well, well, well. What do we have here?
Oh, God.
Just as I suspected, a bunch of thieves.
Excuse me?
Officer Cletus, arrest that kid.
Yes, Cap.
Mom, how?
Let go of him. What do you think you're doing?
Y'all are both under arrest for stealing those hot dogs.
What? We didn't steal anything.
Don't lie to me. I know you're kind, and you people are always stealing things.
Oh, God. I already told you I didn't steal anything.
Oh, yeah? We were watching you from afar, and we saw you steal those hot dogs and didn't pay for them.
You were watching us? We didn't pay because we had a discount.
Oh, let me guess. The five-finger discount?
Oh, my
you
God.
You guys can't fool me.
Mom, we're thugs?
No, baby, we are not. We didn't steal anything, okay? We have these fair and square. You can ask the man over there.
I've heard enough. Officer Cletus, arrest that kid. I'll handle this woman.
What?
Yo, he knocks the hot dog on the ground, bruh.
Officer Cletus, arrest that kid. I'll handle this woman.
Yo, look at him swat the hot dog. What the fuck?
That's what you get for stealing, little monkey boy.
You are under arrest. If you don't stop, I will use lethal force.
Oh my God, yo, what the fuck?
Mom, why are they doing this to us? Did we do something wrong?
Some people don't like us because of the color of our skin. They think because we look like this that we're criminals.
Hey, shut your... Damn, what the fuck? They said, I don't think I want to be black anymore, bro.
Don't you ever say that again. Black is beautiful. Don't you let them break your spirit. I know that it's hard in situations like this, but you've got to stay strong. Do you understand me?
Okay, Mom.
Now you stay here while we run over your IDs and see what other crimes you people have committed.
Yo, is she ad-libbing? Is she, like, she ad-libbing this shit?
What's going on here?
Oh, hey, Mr. Watson. We just caught a couple criminals trying to steal hot dogs from your event.
Trying to steal hot dogs from the event? Is that true?
No, it's not true. We won these hot dogs by solving a puzzle for Word Farm Adventure.
Yeah, right.
It's a new game app that you can...
These people lied to their...
Oh, my God. They all play Word Farm Adventure, and that's what stops racism. Holy shit. Imagine if that's the way they go to really hone in the fucking ad.
Teeth. Getting free hot dogs?
It's just like that commercial with one of the Jenners or one of the fucking Kardashians where she opened the Pepsi can and stopped the fucking war or some shit.
From playing a game? Who would ever believe that?
I would, because it's true. That's one of the event's many deals. I can't believe you did this to them. Well now, release them, this instant.
Sir, I don't think you understand.
I think I understand perfectly fine. Now release them.
Baby, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. But my wrist hurts from those handcuffs.
Look what you did to my son. He's bleeding at the wrist. How do you not have compassion for kids? I told you we were innocent.
You can't blame me. I mean, look at you. Anyone would think you were a criminal.
Excuse me? Why would anybody think she's a criminal?
Come on, sir. I mean, look at her. She's a Negro. It's like, yo, what is the thought process through this shit? Come on, sir. Like, it's undeniable. Look at that weave. Come on now. Yo,
she's
this
just
is
just like
so
any
fuck.
Other person here.
Well, not really.
What are you implying? That because she's black, that she's a criminal? I can't believe what I'm hearing. I'm calling your supervisor and getting you fired off of this event.
No, sir. Please don't do that.
Bruh, you, first of all, we know she's not getting fired. She's getting paid leave, bro.
A body 220 Come on now. Donated $5. You know what? I'm going to play Word Farm Adventure. Thanks, Monkey Boy.
It was all just a big misunderstanding. Right, Cletus?
Yeah, it's all just a big misunderstanding.
Please, sir. I promise you, it'll never happen again. Just give us one more chance.
Okay, but if I catch you
what?
Bothering...
Wait, what?
Hey, Cletus?
Yeah, it's all just a big misunderstanding.
Please, sir.
Oh, my God.
I promise you, it'll never happen again.
This is the most accurate thing that I've seen. So, actually, of all the things in the skit, this is the most accurate part.
Again? Just get...
I didn't know what I was saying when I said it. When I called him a monkey boy, I thought I was being playful. I didn't know it was any racism that stemmed behind the word, it will never happen again. Do you believe what I'm saying? Okay, thank you. Like, how do we constantly believe this bullshit, bro?
Give us one more chance.
Okay, but if I catch you bothering these good people one more time, I'm calling your supervisor as soon as possible.
When I pointed him out specifically because of his skin color and called him a thug, I thought I was doing right to protect the park. I literally thought he had a gun. Based off of his hair and his skin color alone. But now I see in my actions where I have strayed the path. And I hope you accept my apology. It's like, how?
Racist FRL loudly crying bro went out of his way to slap the hot dog out a lil bro.
That's what I'm saying. That was just unnecessary.
So much, sir. You won't regret this.
I hope not. Now get out of here.
Come on, Cletus.
And his name is Cletus.
$5.
You know
Would
he's
you
racist.
Would you act in one of these if they reached out to you, Ty?
I most definitely would. I most definitely would, bro. It would have to be a racist. It would have to be a racist bit, though. I would want it to be like where I'm streaming, and then my chat is just racist to me. My chat is just racist, and I can't take it anymore.
That guy is.
And then I call it would have to be something separate from Twitch because I don't want to get Twitch into it. But it's I'm streaming and like my chat is racist and I can't take it. And then I call like the streaming service head part and then they tell me to deal with it. They say deal with it, black boy, or get off of our fucking streaming service.
Please accept my apologies.
Like I just wanted to be like so out of control, bruh. So where is this like, yo, what the fuck is happening, bro?
$5. These cops are about to get on paid leave thanks to Word Farm Adventure.
Yo, and at the end, I don't even want it to be solved or resolved. I just wanted to be like, I quit streaming and I'm sad and shit, bro.
Some people just don't understand that we're all equal.
I feel like that hits harder.
Or where we're from.
You don't have to apologize.
Try hard. Yes, like, bro, every time I start the stream, like, it's just the try hard emo. And I'm like, yo, guys, what's going on?
Their behavior. Don't worry about it. Unfortunately, we've had this kind of treatment before.
Yo, it's kind of fucked up that's actually something that
My
happens on Twitch.
ISJT
like, if y'all look in the pogger side of Twitch,
My settlement pay better be all the
words. Anytime a black dude pops up on the screen, money. You just see that emote. It's so fucking fucked up.
It doesn't kill you. Make sure
and the fact that that's not like the skit or a parody or any, it's just real life.
Loser
it's like, yikes.
Loser alone donated $5. Get Pokimane to do it with you.
Yo, stop it, man.
Stronger. Right, baby?
I feel stronger already.
Are you participating in the contest?
Yes, sir, we are.
Milksamistire donated $5. You can
That's
keep your
spirit.
Job if you beat this level of work.
Well, come on, guys.
Adventure.
Follow me. The event's about to start.
I can't believe they got away. I mean, how are we supposed to protect our community if we can't keep criminals like them in jail?
The underscore UNV donated $5. You are your chats being racist?
Mr. Watson.
Off our platform, Monkey Man.
He said they didn't do anything wrong.
Mr. Watson doesn't know what he's talking about. He's probably underneath one of their black voodoo spells.
Voodoo spells?
Don't you know anything, Cletus? Voodoo is something black people do to get ahead in life.
Ha!
They cut chicken heads, what? Drink their blood for power.
What the fuck has she been watching?
I'll be tripping. I seen the movie.
Okay, hold on.
Trouser Monster donated $10. Golly, these white MF buggin.
Yo, there's a lot of like racist shit that I know and like I can even joke off of and like, you know, like, you know, monkey shit like that. But it's like, I've never heard that one before. Like, that's a new racist shit to me, bro. I ain't never heard that racist one before. Is have you guys heard of this before? We cut heads of chickens off to get ahead in life and do voodoo and shit?
Then they cast spells on us good, hardworking people. They must have casted plenty of voodoo spells on you already.
What do you mean?
What I mean is I wish that we could get rid of all of them. So this world could be a better place for people like us. I'm tired of everyone protecting these criminals.
Shotty got a gasp for Brett's L actor, W Monkey Boy.
Just cause they're black.
Yo, chill, bro.
Is that voodoo?
That's not voodoo, that's just a fortune teller. But now that I think of it, maybe she can help me figure out how to get these criminals back in jail. Stay here, Cletus, and make sure none of these black people cause any more trouble.
God damn!
Hello? Anyone here?
What the fuck?
Well, hello there, little guy. I know how you feel. No, seriously. Whenever I failed at putting the...
How does this shit not creep her out? But she sees a black mom with her black child and she's like, OH MY GOD, THUGS! Like, what the fuck?
Those thugs in jail, I felt weak, like I was made out of straw. I wish I could make all those black people disappear.
I thought we were the ones that did voodoo!
I'm trying to be annoying, but do you know Fresh and Fit? Would you react to them? Also, First Dono.
Dude, do you see what's happening here? What the fuck are you talking about, dude? Oh my god, this is gonna be like the Twilight Zone where she wishes that it happened, and then when she goes outside, all the things that black people created are no longer there, and she just hates her life because there's like no culture.
Hello, officer.
Oh my god, maybe black people aren't that bad. Oh my god.
I've been waiting for you, Karen.
How do you know my name?
It's my- Of course her name is Karen, bro. Karen and Cletus.
Job to know. Come on, have a seat, dear.
The reason I am here is because...
Give me your hand.
What?
Your right hand. Let me see it. Have you ever had your palm read before?
Nope. This is the first time.
The left hand represents your inborn fate, while your right hand represents your destiny, affected by your acquired environment. There's four major lines. Your lifeline, heart line, head line, and fate line. If your lifeline and your fate line meet in
Look, I don't have time for this. Let's get right to the point. I want you-
I know why you're here. I just like to chat with my visitors before they throw their lives away.
What? What do you mean?
You're here for power, aren't you?
Yes, that's right.
The kind of power to take lives at will.
Yes, especially those dirty black hood rats. You see, I believe-
I am aware of your beliefs, honey. And I have to warn you, they will only lead to destruction. You see, in this earth, we are all-
Sip it, Grandma. I don't want to hear your speeches of equality. I just want you to tell me how to get the power to get rid of all of them at once.
Jesus Christ! Well, there are many. She's literally a supervillain.
Many ways to acquire such power, but they all require you to give up something in return.
I will give them anything. I don't care.
Wait, I ain't gonna lie. I'm kind of invested. Like, this shit need to be a movie, bruh. Like, what's really happening? Donated $5. Like, Scoops, I don't care, and is just acting anymore, man. Yeah, I don't think she's acting. This don't seem like acting. It seems like she really, like, care. This is the most sincere I've seen her.
Well, with what you say, darling, there are spirits all around, watching and paying close attention. We don't want to attract the wrong kind.
I don't care.
She's literally trying to snap us all away.
I'm not afraid of any of them. As long as they can help me get rid of the dirty black people destroying our communities and selling drugs to the kids, I'll give them anything.
Yo, stop watching. What the fuck? Yo, I feel like she just watched, like, just straight 90 hood movies and was like, yo, that's how all of them are, and they will always be like that. Like, yo, damn.
Wow. How did you do that?
I didn't do anything. Look, you better calm down and keep quiet. I put a spell around this place, but it can only control the smaller spirits.
Facts, and talk about it on Facebook.
The reason I know why you're here and what you want is because I had a dream last night. And in that dream, I was told by your spiritual guide that I should help warn you away from your pursuit of power.
What? Why?
It's hard to explain. The dreams I have are not as straightforward as you think. They're full of symbols and metaphors.
Try me.
Well, in my dream, I saw a wolf hunting black sheep. But the wolf's teeth were gone, so it couldn't eat the black sheep.
Are we supposed to be the black sheep?
So it started digging, and it dug until its paws were bleeding. And as it was digging, it came away with a small figure made of straw.
Did you say small figure made of straw?
Yes. Why? Where did that come from?
What do you mean? It was right here on your desk.
No, that's not mine. You need to get rid of it right away.
What? What's the big deal? Just a little straw man. He wouldn't harm a fly.
I said put that down. Now.
Okay, relax. I'm putting him down. What's your problem?
Please tell me that you didn't talk while you were holding it.
Why?
Oh, God, you did. What did you say?
Nothing, really.
Tell me exactly what you said.
I just said that I wished I could make all the black people disappear.
Holy shit. Ain't no way she did it and it actually worked, bro. Like, I'm about to disappear.
Just underscore Nate 06 donated $5. Hey Ty, I copped a 6 hat. And it was all thanks to Word Farm link in the description SYX.
Holy shit, imagine, bro.
What? Why would you say that? How is it that making a wish is the first thing you do?
Cause that hate.
Holding a creepy object in a place like this.
Look, lady, I'm new to this whole thing. How am I supposed to know the rules of what to touch and what not to touch?
Don't you know how to read?
Well, what do we do now?
Well, for starters, let me tell you what you've gotten yourself into. and what demon you've just unleashed.
Oh my god, there actually is a part two!
I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and thanks again to Worst Farm Adventure for sponsoring the episode. If you want to check them...
Wait!
Dante, I gotta head out, but I enjoyed today's stream and will watch your clips on YouTube later.
Much it's over!
Hashtag FNG.
Yo, I appreciate you, man. Hold on, where's the...
Divine Anarchy donated $5. Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good.
Bro, there was never a part two, man. Wait, now I'm really oh my god, now I'm really wondering, like, what happened?
God damn! Sebas de Mofo donated $5.
What a cliffhanger.
The director, like, I don't know why you keep going off script, Karen. Those are not your lines.
Those are not your lines, bro. Those are not your lines. Okay, okay. No, I couldn't find a part two. But okay, there's one more that I want to check out. Do we do one more or do we move on to the next thing? I think we do one more. Listen, look, this is the title. Wife gets caught cheating on husband. And she regrets it. Wife gets caught cheating on husband. Now you know this shit's about to be so stupid. Okay, we'll do this one. We'll do this one then. All right, let's check this out and then we'll move on. Oh my god!
Amanda?
Throw that thing.
Oh my god, what are you doing?
Oh my god, it's so worth it. Okay, I'm glad we did it. Why he gotta be black, bro? Why he gotta be black?
What does it look like I'm doing, David? I'm making love to a man who goes to the gym and is not always working.
Oh my god, like, this is the thing, bro. Like, girls be all over Instagram talking about some, I need a man who gonna pay for me to do this, pay for me to do that. And then be like, yo, you work too much, so I found a nigga who doesn't and has less money, but he's built. Black Panther, it's like, what?
Karen is the villain and she becomes a demon.
That boy went down to his hands and knees and started crying, bro. You cheated on me. Not only that, it's a
like what you see, baby?
Not really. It looks like you've gotten fatter.
I don't think I'm getting fatter. Honey, you know I can't go to the gym like I used to. I've been working overtime at the hospital.
Well, can't you work out before you go to the hospital? Or afterwards? Maybe you can lift one of those cancer patients and use them as weights.
How can you say something like that? Those are human beings. Besides, I told you, I'm not working with cancer patients anymore. They have me on COVID cases.
Hold on, bitch, why don't you stand up?
I've been so overwhelmed, and those people need all the time that I can give them.
I could care less about these COVID people. They all could just die if it were up to...
If you could care less, then that means you still... That means you could still care? Because isn't it, I couldn't care less? I could care less, which means, I don't know. I thought it was
to me. This is just like the flu, but people are overreacting. And wasn't it you that said,
oh, she's one of those, bruh. She's one of those, man.
Fat people that are dying. It's a service to society, if you ask me.
No, that's not what I said. And you know it.
Yo, when they do these skits, they go above and beyond, like, what is needed for the fucking bit. We know she's a fucking dick, bro. God damn. Like, if you just showed us body, like, when she was like, ew, that's your body. Like, yo, we knew from there. She's an asshole. But damn, they really hammer it to you, man. When they're bad, they're bad. When they're good, bro.
What I said was that people with pre-existing conditions are getting hit the hardest because their bodies are under so much strain.
Message!
By the way, aren't your parents seriously overweight?
Yes, they are. And I pray that they get COVID and die off faster. And just give me my inheritance. I'm just so sick of going to their birthday parties every year.
Oh my god! What the f-
Like, you're 60 years old. How old can you keep on living? And why would they even want to keep on-
Yo. I want y'all to get this, okay? We hear what she's saying. We hear how she's talking, right? if that wasn't enough for the skit to make you understand that she's a bad person and doesn't care about anything, look at the fucking books she's reading. How to Swear. Holy shit. Like, how hard do they need to hammer this shit in, bro? Like, are you kidding me?
On living. It's not like they're of any service to society.
Jesus Christ.
Sometimes when you talk like that, I don't know if you actually mean it or if it's just stress.
Nah, man, I've been stressed before and I never talked about some shit like this, bro. Holy shit.
Or something. I have an idea. Why don't you let the good doctor relieve some of that stress for you?
I'm not in the mood, David.
Really?
I ain't gonna lie. This dude should have been with, he should have been talking to, like, or should meet the other girl with the son who's a fucking dick. They'd be perfect for each other.
It's been like 6 months since we made love. Are you sure?
6 months!
What if we spice things up a little bit?
Ew, David. You know I do not like that kind of stuff.
You boring as fuck.
I hate when people get weird like that. And I already told you, I'm not in the mood.
You are boring as fuck. Yo, I'm leave sorry. Her, bruh.
You know I respect you and your body, and I will just wait till you're in the mood.
Oh, dude.
But you're going to be waiting a very long time.
This is not a relationship. This is not a relationship at all. I don't know what this is.
Oh, my God. Honey, I'm so sorry. I gotta go back into the hospital as soon as possible. They're bringing in a whole busload of kids with COVID from an orphanage.
Maybe they should have asked their parents to take better care of them.
As David was getting ready to go back to the hospital, Amanda was also getting ready by messaging guys on Tinder and telling them to come over for an easy score. See, what David didn't know is that every night when he was at work in the hospital, Amanda would have a new guy come over from Tinder.
Every night? With her. What the fuck? This is the most L situation I've ever seen.
Here we go. 40th guy this month. One more and I'll beat my personal record.
Yo! Yo, they said every night she has a new guy. You mean like men? Multiple? A day? A night?
I can't believe I've let all these men have unprotected love with me.
What?
And I haven't even gotten pregnant or any diseases. Maybe that's all just a fairy tale like COVID.
Oh, she's for the fucking streets! She's for the fucking streets!
Amanda?
Black Hercules?
What the?
Imagine the casting calls for these roles looks like. I'm crying GGGGG.
Oh my God, yo, I'm dead. I'm fucking dead, bro.
Well, that was racist. But since I'm about to punish you really hard, I'll allow it.
Come in. Make yourself at home. Can I get you anything to drink?
I'll take a bottle of water. They have some.
There you go.
By the way, I brought something for you. Something for us to play with.
A belt.
Oh, I don't know what the fuck. I thought he was about to pull out something crazy, bro. I thought he was about to pull out something crazy.
I love it when people get freaky with me.
Yo, fuck her, for real, for real. What the fuck? We see the mic
with me.
We see the mic on the belt.
She said 40th guy that month, but there's only 31 days in a month.
That's what I'm saying.
She definitely took 9 guys in one go around.
She's getting gangbanged, bro. The microphone. It's literally pulling up her dress in the back. But whatever.
While Amanda and Tyrone were in bed, David was on his way back.
Why y'all name him Tyrone? Why y'all name him Tyrone, bruh? Like, damn. Nigga's name couldn't be Dave or something?
D old Tim donated $5. Shoddy a demon. I'd still hit can't cap, though.
You're disgusting. She has unprotected sex with 40 men a month.
From the hospital. Doctors from all over the city had shown up to help, and they no longer needed David.
Mm.
Honey, I'm home. Got you some of your favorite chocolates. No, you probably haven't had them in a while since you've been on a diet.
She definitely has some chocolate, dog.
Amanda? Hello? I brought you some chocolate.
Laughing, that's weird. She never laughs.
Sorry, brother. She already got enough chocolate for a whole year.
Amanda? Oh my God, what are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing, David? I'm making love to a man who goes to the gym and is not always working.
But I love you with all my heart. Remember our wedding vows? There were good times and bad. It's okay. We can go to counseling. We can still work this out.
Look, David, Tyrone has worked me out all night tonight. Plus, I don't love you, okay?
Oh my God.
I only wanted the attention and the gifts that come with weddings. All women want that.
Wait, they got married. Well, it said husband. I didn't even realize they
we
were
just
married.
Don't admit it. We peak in high school, and we want to feel that feeling again. Plus, you were fit
Fred
when I met you.
$5. I'm guessing Word Farm Adventures don't pay her cause she deaf not letting dudes hit for free if she getting clapped 40 times a month.
Yo, imagine if this was the other way around, bro. This shit is crazy.
Now look at you.
Look at his face. He's gonna break down, man. This is so fucked up.
Fat like a pig. Disgusting.
Yo, get up, man.
Baby.
Stop.
I love you so much. I love you with all my heart, please.
You better than this, dog. You better than this. I ain't gonna lie, y'all. Yo, if y'all ever have somebody treat you like this, do not get on your hands and knees crying and begging for her to stop. She clearly don't give a fuck. Leave her, bro. Leave her and just do 10 times better, bro. Be more successful and all that shit and forget she even existed. It is not worth the stress. She's clearly showing she's not worth the stress, bro.
Imagine an ad in the middle of them getting busy.
Holy shit, man.
Tonight was a crazy adventure, but not as crazy as Word Farm Adventure.
Imagine.
Hey, you're a doctor, right?
Yeah.
Can you take a look at this mole on my abs? I'm afraid it might be something dangerous.
Okay.
What do you call a Mexican without a car? Carlos, please don't ban me.
Protect people.
Dude! Oh God, this is... Oh.
Tyrone! Stop that! Let's get out of here!
Bye!
What do you call a Mexican? Amanda packs her things and leaves
Carlos,
with Tyrone. After 3 months of working on himself, David was able to get his life back on track. He even got a promotion at the hospital and became one of their top doctors. He started working out and getting in shape. Meanwhile, things weren't looking so great for Amanda. She later realized that Tyrone did not have a job.
Well, he had so much time. Like, what the fuck? Do people not understand this shit? If a nigga has all the time in the world to just be with you, he's either just not working, or even if he works from home, you still got to be working. You still going to be away from her. So it's like, yo, do you want a dude that's always around you but not making money, or a dude that's like sometimes has to be gone but is making all this money? Like, what do you want, bruh?
All he would do was go to the gym and take steroids. He would come
sleep.
Home from the gym
and beat her.
And then emotionally
yeah.
abuse
yeah.
her.
Yeah! Hell yeah! Bitch!
Amanda.
No, bro. Yo, if he takes her back, I swear, bro.
This is a surprise.
I hope they sleep together and he catch something because he a dumbass, bro. Come on, bro. Be stronger than this. You do not need her. She is not for you. Come on, please, brother.
UNB
please, my dude.
$5.
I'm rooting for you, man.
Grow better than me, skull. I would have told him the mole is stage 4 cancer.
I would have said some fucked up shit too, bro. The fuck you think you about to leave here happy with my wife? The fuck?
Guys, how are things with Tyrone?
Well, Tyrone is a gym freak. It's all he thinks about.
Close the door on her.
We can't talk about anything else, and he treats me like garbage.
Deserved.
So I had to leave him.
Well, I'm glad that you got the courage to stand up for yourself and find a better life.
Yes, exactly. And who else to give me a better life than you? My favorite doctor in the world.
I'm sorry, but I've moved on.
Yeah!
I finally learned how to respect and value myself. And I could never be with someone like you.
Good shit! The fuck out of here, bitch!
Now.
Oh!
And she loves me for who I am.
Okay!
Not for what my abs look like.
Bring her to the door!
David, I love you.
Oh, and you sick!
Good. Should probably get that cough checked out.
Oh!
Might be COVID.
Oh!
It's really important to remember that true beauty is on the inside. We need to be with people who love us for who we are, not what we look like. After all, looks fade over time, but what's inside only grows stronger. Thanks so much for watching this video, and remember to share with your friends and family. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe.
This was a W.
And here at Generation Hope, we're making the world a better place, one story at a time.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about, bruh. That's what I like to see. That video was beautiful, bro. That was beautiful, bro. Oh my gosh, that was literally perfection. It was literally perfection, bro. Oh my god, I love that. I absolutely love that. That was probably my favorite one, bro. That was probably my favorite one in terms of like the story. As far as entertainment, probably the that Xbox one was pretty entertaining. I ain't gonna lie. He was really getting on his mom like that. The second one was crazy though. That one, like, I would really like watch that. I wanna see more of that. Wait, is that really part 2 of the voodoo? Wait, it really dropped? Hold on, let me bring up my Twitch over here. No, it's not. It's a meme. It's a troll. It's a troll video. I knew it. I literally called it, so it don't count. I literally only called it, so it don't matter, bro.